that you will get me my similar looking buck. I will show you the buck, but first I need to understand how. How? What is visual instructions?
And then.
Now that's copying. That's not instruction. Copying is easy. That, you know, MS Office when they launch, no, they give control C, control V by default. Any other ideas? Somebody is mumbling to themselves, I can't hear. Yes, any other ideas? How do we get signal perspective? How do we get the thinking for all of us we think?
When we understand each other.
Sorry?
When we understand each other.
How will you understand me? Come here, tell me. I'm excited to hear about how you will understand this teacher. Please tell. These teachers also want to know how you will understand. Yes, anyone else? How? And what would this be? This is coming from a teacher, so I hope it's really, thank God. Yes, ma'am.
More clarity in your instruction.
How can I give more clarity? What would they be? You're there, but not yet. Anyone else? Yes.
Clarity in the sense, for example, one leg is longer than the other. It was not mentioned that either to the left or either to the right.
I mentioned that also.
Yes.
When you first told us to draw the circle, you did not tell the radius of the circle. You could have told that.
That I should have given him the radius, right? And our label here has something that says
measurement of each line or circle, whatever.
Absolutely. So now the learning comes to this. How many of you asked me questions? I told something. Did any of you ask me for the measurement? Did anybody ask me for the size? Did anyone ask me anything? Same set of instructions, what would you? No, no, I'm going to give you the same set of drawings now, and I'm going to say that you need to get it as similar as mine. So, same as the kata is there, and there is a soup, and, but nothing is made. Huh? This is there. So, how do you refine your question every time somebody gives you information is the first and most crucial aspect of success. When I say, what's your name? Yes.
Skanda.
Skanda, okay. So I'm going to say, Skanda, you're looking very smart. Everybody clap for Skanda. You look very smart. What should you ask me? I just gave you a compliment. What will you ask me? Yes, you have to ask me some question. What will you ask? How? I don't know how. This is the silly question. Now he's going to ask the correct question, okay? How? I don't know. You should tell me how. But anyway, I don't want to know how. I'm only telling you that Skanda, you're looking very smart today. Huh?
Only smart.
Yeah. To me, you're looking only smart. This is also a silly question. He's going to ask the correct question now. Next.
Why?
Yes. Yes. So the question here is not how, it is not where, when and all that. The question here is why. So I'll tell him, I think it's the white shirt without the blue blazer, it's making you stand out in front of everyone. Everybody else is wearing blue, you're the only one without the jacket. Okay? This is visibility problem. He got covered by those jackets. You bring that. Okay. So, quickly, what did we understand? English has, all languages have the question formats, what, why, when, who, where and all. You need to know when you should ask what question, please sir. Right? So that's the first. Go to the next. That was my bug. Okay? Yay! But it's not the same. So we have some amazing artists is what I found out. Some beautiful drawings. But we did not get it exactly looking like mine, and it is not possible. because we did not get the details correct. Move to the next slide. Okay. Forget all of this.
Iron Man.
Let's look at this. Okay, how many of you have seen all the movies? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Avengers, Avengers, all movies? Any one movie? One Avenger movie? Okay, alright, fine. Put your hands down. This is, okay. Settle. So this image, okay, is what we use every time when we talk to any student. The reason is everybody connects to it, okay, because it's a movie and I like all of them. My favorite Iron Man is missing, but that's okay. If you were to look at the Avengers team, how many of you like Spider-Man the most? Please hands. No? There's one? There's only one. Okay. How many of you like Iron Man? I'll also raise hands. No maps, not seen. You see? Alright, you can also join hands with them. Even one the scene is also good enough. Who likes Hulk? We had some, sorry. Okay, good. What about Captain America? We have some people. How about our lady here?
Romanov.
Yeah, Black Widow, thank you. So, we all watched a movie and we like different characters. Why? So, time for you to introspect. Why do you like the character you like?
Mindset.
Whichever character it is.
Mindset.
What mindset? That's okay. You repeated it for him. Yes.
We get connected with those characters easily.
Why? What is your favorite star?
Ma'am, I like Hulk the most.
Why?
Ma'am, because maybe any of the characters in us which we love the most, we see in those characters. And we likely go into those characters in the film.
So what characteristics of Hulk do you feel is connected with you?
Ma'am, not like connected, ma'am, but in those series, I like just the Hulk the most, but other movies of Disney, I like them most, ma'am. Like, for example, like girls like Disney and Cinderella, etc. characters, we love the most, but actually when it comes to the Avengers, I like the Hulk because of his appearance and his strength and many other characters, I like the Hulk.
Okay, she says she's connected to Hulk's strength. Okay, anyone else? Come on, some other characteristic, yes.
I like Iron Man because he's a common man, he's a human who has no superpowers. Through his intelligence, he has got all those superpowers. He has made a suit for himself. Tony Stark, I like the most for his intelligence.
Okay, intelligence is what connects him. Anyone else? Come on, stand up for the character you will pick. We finished Hulk and we've got Iron Man. Anyone else? You have to connect. You can also connect with someone else who's not in the picture. So let's say you don't like anyone in Avengers, but you pick someone else. I don't know, anywhere from Mahatma Gandhi to Ma Saraswati, I'm really not worried. So if you can connect to a character, I want you to tell me why. Or what is the reason for the connect? Shall we ask your teachers? Yes.
Because of her selfless service.
So Ma'am likes Mother Teresa because of her selfless service. And we have, yes, you should always clap.
And Kicha Sudip. Attitude.
Come on. Okay. Anyone else? Character that you resonate with?
Rich man for his beard. Rocking stylish. For his beard.
You know, you get 1 second of your life back to you. So if you clap 30 times, that's 30 seconds of your life. So even if you're not clapping for somebody else, clap for yourself. Shanti is good. Alright? Come on. In the last 5 minutes, different people like different people for different reasons. Was any of the reason marks or grades? Yes? Do we know the marks of the Yash rocking star who has a great beard? No. Do we know marks of Mother Teresa?
No.
Do we know Iron Man's marks?
No.
We don't. What do we know? We know their personality, we know their characteristic, and we connect with that. Yes? Now tell me, what are you going to do to build your personality and grades? This doesn't mean that you don't focus on grades. Grades gives you what it gives you, but personality is what takes you forward. So what should we do to build personality? What should we do? What is the personality that you can connect with? Okay, how are we on time? Sorry. Half an hour, alright. Okay, let's try and see how many things we can get out. Yes, what is personality? Okay, how many of you are fighters? How many of you will fight for anything that you think is right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suddenly so many hands going up. Yes, all fighters. Yes? Any more fighters? How many of you, now those who have declared that they are fighters cannot raise hands, okay? You have to be conscious to yourself. How many of you are doers? Somebody will tell you to do something, you will do it no matter what. Sir, only we will be category. Nobody wants to do anything. I'm very worried, guys. If everyone is going to fight and nobody is going to do, I'm not really sure how we're going to make India better. Okay. How many of you like to give instructions? What about the rest, yeah? What are you gonna do? One is poor. No, only 2, 3. Well done, put your hands down. So 2 wants to give instructions, maybe 3, 4 more at the most. Majority of them are eaters, and then some of them, no, sorry, no some of them, just the 2 of us are doers. And what category do the rest of you belong? Listening? Listening. That I saw in my house, love listening. I saw the listening skills. Yes. What category do you fit?
Speakers.
Let me. This is your speaker. Come forward. Let's hear you speak.
Sorry, ma'am.
No, sorry. Why? Why do you have to be sorry? There's no need to be sorry in life. Seriously. Come on. 30 seconds. How many? 1 second of clap is 1 second of life. About yourself? No, yourself. School is okay. School, they will take care of PR. You take care of your own PR. Public relations for yourself. 30 seconds and you will speak for yourself. Yes?
Good afternoon. My name is Kanda. ನಾನು ಎಸ್ ಜೆ ಎಲ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿ ಕೆ ಜಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾನು ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಮತ್ತೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಿ ಕೆ ಜಿ ಎಲ್ ಕೆ ಜಿಯಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ತುಂಟ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಹಂಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಓದ್ತೀನಿ ಹಂಗೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಓದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಮಾಡೋ ಜೋಕ್ಸಿಗೂ ನೀವು ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀರ ಜೋಕ್ಸೇ ನಾನೇ ಲಾಭ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು ಲವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸುಮಾರು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ನಮಗೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಂಟರ್ಟೈನ್ಮೆಂಟು ಮತ್ತೆಲ್ಲ ಆಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ
suddenly he didn't expect that I was going to give him 30 seconds. He was not prepared. He didn't know what to say, so he said whatever he felt like. Luckily, there was nothing at stake for him, which means nothing that he was going to lose. He did not lose, but he did not gain also. Now, I'll explain what this means. Right now, there are, I guess, three schools. Am I right? One school. Okay. One school in different classes? Only the 10th grade. Okay. 10th, and there are so many of you. When you go out, when you step out, there are going to be so many of the other schools, other grades, one grade lesser, one grade higher, and some of your similar grades all coming out in terms of competition. Correct? We just agreed that grades are important, but personality is the thing to go for, because that's what is remembered. Right? Now, if you're going to get an opportunity like how Skanda got, what is it that you will say about yourself? What is it that you will talk about yourself? How many of you have or remember your personality, your character based on what other people have said? For example, somebody says that, oh, she's an amazing girl, so you think you're amazing. Somebody has said, oh, he's slow, so you think that you're also slow. Do you remember characteristics that you have identified? Or do you know characteristics that has been told by others? Yes.
Not Richard, I am an actor with drama. So after realizing teachers when told them, then I realized that I can.
Okay, very good. Anyone else? Yes, clap. You can always clap. That was amazing. Happiness should come from within. Your want for life should come from within. One second, life increase should come from within. Yes, anybody else who remembers their characteristics or skills because somebody else said so? Do you remember things that you said about yourself? 99.9% of the time, we have not even thought who we are. We have always heard either what our mother, father, our siblings, could be either sister, brother, cousins, grandfathers who could have scolded us, or grandmothers who could have been very nice to us, or the surrounding neighbors, or the teachers, friends. It's always what we hear from the other person is what we think we are. And that's not true. It's never true. Most people are being the way they can be in front of strangers first, and then you decide how to continue the relationship. Do you see, have you been told it is? Yes? Sorry, ma'am? Feelings we will express. Ma'am says feelings we will express, and it is nothing more than that. How many times do we think of situations in life when anger has to be used and tears have to be used? Which means those are also strengths, right? The only thing that makes it a plus or a minus according to the society is when you use it. So every emotion that you have, every so-called ability or inability that you have depends upon the situation and has got nothing to do in the form of a weakness or a strength. So what do? You only understand the situation and bring about the best for that situation. Right? Similarly, when you sit back, when you go back home today, how many of you have access to Google? You never know, ma'am. Some of our engineering students, they come and say, ma'am, I don't have mobile also. So, okay, great. So what I want you to do, go back home and do this exercise. If you, normally we don't remember personalities and characteristics. We keep saying we are nice, we are good, we are better, that's it. A lot of amazing vocabularies that English has given us. I want you to draw a mind map. You can come back and show it to your teachers tomorrow. Your mind map is nothing but a reflection of yourself. How many of you can draw? Please answer. Draw. A lot of people can draw, I saw that. But how many of you can actually like drawing? How many of you like music? Okay. How many of you like dance? How many of you like to watch movies? Okay, how many of you like to play video games? This is good. This is good. Better than watching movies, no? Alright, what I want you to do is go back and you know how mind maps are done? Mind maps is nothing but you draw circles which represents your mind and then you channel them out into different things. So what I want you to do is put a circle and put one talent of yours, which could be talking, which could be dance, singing, music, cooking, whatever the thing might be that you really think you're good at. And I want you to branch out, okay? And you can Google for this. You can branch out saying, what jobs can I do with this as my skill? Even if you put talking is my skill or sleeping is my skill, you will get jobs. Yes, I'm not joking, yes. Okay, I forgot to ask. How many of you like sleeping? Please raise your hand. Ma'am, nobody, ma'am. Just relax. Okay, guys, put your hands down. Okay, so yes. Yes, Kanda.
Nothing. Raising hands.
Put hands down. Okay, so I want you to spend time whenever you can, but do show it to your teachers. I'm sure they'll be able to help you out. There is no such thing as right and wrong. You can choose to do what you want to do. And every ability of yours has a career today, right? The point in the end is what you really want to do. You can do your regular degree, you can pick up any academics that you want, get the right grades, build your personality and then choose the job that you want. Just because you're doing engineering does not mean that you have to only be in the line of engineering. You can do something else. You can mix engineering with dance, you can mix engineering with sports, you can mix engineering with, anything. You can mix agriculture and engineering, you can mix management with everything. So there's a lot of options available, so do create some mind maps. It'll help every student, it helps every individual, it can even help teachers. Okay? This is a universal tool. Second thing is building personality. When you're creating these mind maps, each opportunity or each job has a set of personality requirements. Okay? And it will tell you, you can Google this also, it will tell you what personality is required. It might say you need to be an extrovert, you need to be an introvert, you need to be able to have a certain type of skills, you need to be having 100% integrity, which means no matter what you will not tell a lie. Those kind of things. So you can introspect and write it down. Then you can sit back and think whether you really have it in you or not. Then we can start talking about how to build it. There are some games which I can probably try next time if ever I see you, otherwise I can pass it on to some of the teachers and then you can try this out. Questions not have to be anything what they want to hear, but the question has to be what you want to ask. Curiosity keeps you going and at the end you can make sure that those people who are curious, who are continuously learning, are the ones who build the best personality. I want to give you one more life example. I finished my 12th grade in 94, I think. Okay, I'm really bad with dates, but 94 seems likely the right timeline. I was in India, but I finished my education in Dubai, like I mentioned to you. And I did not realize, my marks for business communication came at 38. In everything else, it was at 18 plus. Okay? And I was in India, I did not know this. And suddenly I got a call and then I was told that I have to repeat an exam. And I did not even know back then that we could reapply the correction of papers or whatever. I did not know that because I did not even think on those lines. I was one of those super confident saying that, oh, mere paper ka kya hoga, it'll all be fine. You know, that kind of an attitude I went with in an exam, I wrote whatever I wanted to write and I came out. But at that point of time, I had choices, of course. I could cry and I could create a scene. I could feel miserable because all the other people who were terrible has also finished and they have taken admissions. Now I have to start getting upset with my parents saying that it is all your fault because I was in India but you were there in Dubai, you could have sent my papers for reapplication, but they didn't. They also didn't know that there was something called as a reapply and we just lost the opportunity to reapply. But I had no choice, so I had to rewrite the paper the same year. And I had aims of going to UK and finishing my higher studies. And that didn't work out obviously because of this change in timeline. And then I had to decide what is it that I want to do. I still didn't know. Like I said, we didn't have Google and we didn't have WhatsApp, so we just have to take decisions by ourselves. And highly influential society, I'll tell you why. Because as it is, India has got its influence within the society and you've got your peers to manage. What happens to those people who go abroad? You know, those people who go abroad, they're very worried that they lose their culture. So they're super strict, like they're super, super, super strict. They decide to implement 116 on top of over what is already in the culture. They do more than that. In this process, you really know what to do, right? And I had to take a call. And then, my father could not afford to pay for two education, which means my brother who was finishing his engineering and I who finished my degree, we ended up at the same timeline because of that back paper of mine. Now, obviously my father has to decide. Indian society always, back those days at least, was like, oh, first the son will study, then only the daughter will study. So I went through similar issues. Again, I can choose to complain or I can choose to do something about it. So I chose to do something. I said, yeah, school is school, college is college. Either I want to go to an IIM or an IIT and do something, or I just have to do something else. So the first thing my brother said was, I don't think you can clear IIT and IIM and all. This is typical brother. Okay, this is typical brother those days. I don't know if typical brother these days are any better, but sibling those days was like this. And I was like, oh, okay, I can't do it. Influenced by society, by family, you know, this is what normally happens. But somewhere I felt that after I came back to India, I felt that I should do something. So I applied for civil services. I took up the papers. I did not join any tutorials and I cleared all the way around. I went to the final interview as well. Everything